Hi, it's Katrina. From college clubs who don't even reveal their members to gatherings limited to members of society's most elite, here are eight of the world's most mysterious secret societies. Number 8. Cadaver Society. The Cadaver Society is an organization of students at Washington and Lee University in Lexington, Virginia. Its membership is thought to consist mostly of older students, possibly including pre-med majors, athletes, and/or fraternity members. But nobody knows for sure, because the Cadaver Society's membership, requirements for joining, and organizational structure have successfully been kept secret since the club was founded in 1957. Their symbol is a skull and the letter C, which they like to leave all over the place. Rumors hold that members travel to meetings using underground passageways. Suspected entrances to these tunnels include a small door in Layburn Library, suspicious locked doors in the science building's basement, a maintenance gate, and various manhole covers. The organization proudly donates large amounts of money to the university. In 1988, it gave $150,000 toward remodeling fraternity houses. The Cadavers created a scholarship in 1997, which is awarded to an incoming freshman every 4 years. Members also engage in less formal activities, like placing their symbol all over campus, running through sorority houses with high-pitched voices to wake up the sleeping girls, and other shenanigans, all while dressed in black robes and caps that conceal their identities. Washington and Lee University is also home to another mysterious club called the Sigma Society, which was founded 70 years earlier than the Cadaver Society. Like the Cadaver Society, the Sigma Society's activities and headquarters are shrouded in secrecy, but unlike the other club, its membership is not anonymous. In the Cadavers, no one knows who the members are, but in Sigma, everyone knows you are in a secret society, but not what you are doing. Which would you prefer? Let me know in the comments below. Number 7. International Order of Saint Hubertus. The International Order of Saint Hubertus made headlines in 2016 following the death of Supreme Court Justice Antonin Scalia, who spent his last hours surrounded by members of the organization. Founded in Austria in 1695, the IOSH, or IOSH, was originally a fraternity of elite hunters. It was dissolved during World War II and re-emerged after the war. Today, the club is worldwide. There are around 700 members, with the U.S. chapter being the largest. Members are dedicated to hunting, fishing, wildlife habitat improvement, and conservation of game species, according to the Order's website. Some ways members contribute to these causes are through monetary and land donations. Individuals within the organization have also worked toward honorable causes on their own accord, such as protecting elephants from poachers. They wear dark green robes featuring a cross, along with the Latin motto, Deum diligite animalia diligentes, which translates to honoring God by honoring his creatures. The organization is non-denominational, however. The Grand Duchy of Luxembourg is currently the Order's Grand Master. While the Order itself is not a secret, membership is restricted to men and by invitation only, and what goes on at their meetings is largely unknown. Number 6. Seven Society. The Seven Society was supposedly founded in 1905 at the University of Virginia in Charlottesville when 8 students arranged to meet for a card game and only 7 showed up. But nobody knows if this story is true, except maybe the club's members. In fact, very little is known about the Seven Society in general, aside from its philanthropic tendencies and good deeds. Like many secret clubs, the Seven Society has a reputation for being generous toward university-related causes, often making donations in amounts containing lots of sevens. Seven Society members' identities are revealed after their deaths when the club places a wreath of black magnolias in the shape of a seven on their grave. In memory of the deceased, the university chapel bells, which were a gift from the society, toll in 7-second increments in a seventh dissonant chord on the 7th minute of the hour for 7 minutes. Those wishing to communicate with the Seven Society can do so by leaving a note in the university rotunda at the base of the Thomas Jefferson statue or in the crook of its arm. The club's mysterious seven symbol is painted in front of the rotunda, so if you're planning to leave any correspondence, you'll know you're in the right place. The Seven Society rarely addresses the public. In 2012, the organization made headlines for displaying banners around campus reminding students to be kinder to each other following a series of upsetting crimes and incidents. Number 5. Opus Dei. A Spanish Catholic priest, who eventually became a saint, named José María Escrivá, founded Opus Dei in 1928 on the basis of his belief that essentially anyone can be called to religious work and incorporate sanctity into their daily lives. As inclusive as this sounds, and despite the group's assertion that they are not a secret society, they are incredibly secretive and have been criticized for their elusive nature. By the time Opus Dei was approved as part of the Catholic Church in 1950, the organization was already being compared to the Freemasons, and not in a good way. Father Escrivá also fell under scrutiny for his close relationship with fascist dictator Francisco Franco. He included several of its members in instituting economic reform, so many started to think that Opus Dei had political ambitions. Many intellectuals belong to Opus Dei, and they have founded and endowed many schools and universities around the world, such as the University of Navarra in Spain and the Pontifical University of the Holy Cross in Rome, with assistance from governments and the Vatican. As you probably know, Opus Dei was featured in the book and film The Da Vinci Code as condoning or even encouraging religious self-harm, bringing even more controversy and unwanted publicity to the organization. What's true and what's not is a matter of debate when it comes to Opus Dei. Membership is kept secret, which is why people consider it a secret society. Members are only allowed to reveal themselves as such at the direction of a superior, and an estimated 20% of members live in closed-off communities and have little contact with the outside world. Some critics even claim that joining one of these enclaves is like entering the Hotel California. You can check yourself in, but you may not be able to leave by your own free will. And contact with friends and family is allegedly heavily discouraged. Number 4. Knights of Pythias. A government employee named Justice E. Rathbone founded the Knights of Pythias in Washington, D.C. in 1864 during the Civil War, out of a perceived moral need for an organization that practiced brotherly love. It was the first fraternal organization chartered by an act of Congress. The fraternity's emblem contains the letters FCB, which stand for Friendship, Charity, Benevolence. And their motto is to speak the truth and to render benefits to each other. Former Presidents William McKinley, Warren G. Harding, and Franklin D. Roosevelt were members, as well as Nelson Rockefeller and Louis Armstrong. Today, the Knights of Pythias is partners with the Boy Scouts of America and an ardent supporter of the American Cancer Society, with additional focuses on providing homes to older members and helping underprivileged children. Many former Pythian lodges are on the U.S. National Register of Historic Places or are listed with the National Park Service. The organization has limited transparency, however. There is no central register of deceased members, and their internal activities are highly secretive. Number 3. Skull and Bones. Of course, this one's on this list. Founded in 1832, Skull and Bones is comprised of undergraduate seniors at Yale University. It's also known as the Order, Order 322, and the Brotherhood of Death. Skull and Bones could be considered Yale's best-kept, worst-kept secret, author Alex Nowicki wrote in an Education Dive article. While everyone knows about it, no one really knows about it. The same can be said for all of these, really. Skull and Bones is a popular topic for conspiracy theories and has made numerous appearances in pop culture, including books and movies. Who knows what rumors are and aren't true? One circulating was that the CIA created Skull and Bones as a pipeline of employees from Yale, but that's probably not true. Or is it? Rumors aside, Skull and Bones is legitimately shrouded in mystery. The group's headquarters is a windowless structure called the Tomb, and only members know what goes on at meetings. 15 men and women are selected as new members every spring on what's known as Tap Day. The society owns and manages an island retreat called Deer Island. When it comes to their activities, well, your guess is as good as any other non-members. Notable members include George W. Bush, as well as his father and grandfather. Senators, court justices, presidents, and William Howard Taft, who was both president and Supreme Court Chief Justice, have come from Skull and Bones. Number 2. Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn. The first temple of the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn was established in London in 1888. Its three founders were former members of the Freemasons and the English chapter of the Rosicrucians, who were fascinated by things like magic, alchemy, and astronomy. Their goal was to unify all existing religions under a set of beliefs bearing characteristics similar to modern-day Wicca and occult practices. In fact, the Golden Dawn was one of the most influential organizations on 20th-century occultism. Its philosophy was grounded in supernatural beliefs rather than religion, and was therefore very different from the beliefs of the Freemasons and Rosicrucians. Unlike many secret societies, especially of the past, the Hermetic Order admitted both men and women. This bizarre organization had many notable members, including poet William Butler Yeats, Bram Stoker from Dracula, and Arthur Conan Doyle from Sherlock Holmes. One of the founders left in 1896 after his colleagues discovered his membership and alienated him, and another resigned in 1901. The Golden Dawn lost most of its power and prestige from there, and while it technically still exists in the form of an interesting self-help club with cultish overtones, it has not been restored to its former glory. Number 1. The Bilderberg Group. The Bilderberg meeting dates back to 1954. It's an annual gathering of around 130 wealthy and powerful personalities, and was created with the express purpose of getting the who's who of the world's governments and financial sectors together in one place. The meeting's attendees are far from secret. Some prominent people who attended this year's event were Henry Kissinger, Jared Kushner, U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, and Mark Carney, Governor of the Bank of England. There is an official website dedicated to the Bilderberg meeting, but oddly, not all of this year's attendees were listed on the official roster. The original Bilderberg Group was founded by a CIA head, a prince of the Netherlands, the Unilever chairman, and a former prime minister of Belgium. Their supposed goal was to fight back against perceived anti-American sentiments throughout Western Europe. The first meeting was so successful, it became an annual event and is held at a different location every year. Not surprisingly, the event has attracted numerous conspiracy theories with themes along the lines of a new world order and the global domination of the elite. It is true that the place is heavily policed, but so is any place where you'll find high-profile figures. However, in addition to the top-notch security, there's an understanding among attendees that what goes on at the meeting stays there, just like Las Vegas. Thanks for watching! There's more where that came from. Would you like to learn more about secret societies? Which one would you want to join? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. See you next time. Bye!